can see it here on the satellite and radar, just how much of the eastern Gulf of Mexico the storm takes up. That contributes to the storm surge, which you've heard about. More water getting pushed up ahead of the storm. That's what causes that surge there. But I want to zoom in a little bit closer. As of 2 o'clock our time, the latest update showing maximum winds with Helene right around the eye wall. That's this area here, sustained at 125 miles per hour. Now that's over open water. Unlikely that we'll actually see observed winds over land at that strength, but we are going to see damaging winds out of the storm. We likely already have. These numbers here are forecast wind gusts. Keep in mind, it's a forecast, not perfect, but you see here, even along the Gulf Coast of Florida, where the eye of the storm is staying offshore, we could see some wind gusts well over tropical storm force between 60 and 70 miles per hour along the immediate shoreline. As we go through this evening, the storm expected to make landfall at about 7 or 8 o'clock our time. Notice, even as we go through tonight, the center of the storm, the strongest part of the storm, moves well away from the warm water. That's its energy source. But this area of purple representing wind gusts potentially over a tropical storm force across much of Georgia, South Carolina, and into North Carolina as well. So this storm's going to maintain some strength as it moves northward too. And of course, another component, just how much rain this storm is bringing too. This is future cast showing the approximate area of landfall. Again, this is 8 o'clock our time, so 11 p.m. local time there on the East Coast. Look at all of the rain streaming northward out ahead of this. All of that tropical moisture getting lifted northward by a second system that's actually much farther to the north. And then as we go through the next couple of days, yeah, that rain is just going to continue to fall across parts of the Mississippi Valley and into parts of the Mid-Atlantic there. Now, some good news there. This rain is falling over an area that really could use it at this point, but there will be serious flooding from eastern Tennessee southward into Florida. We'll keep an eye on it. Back to you.